It's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, StraightSmileSolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about two orthodontic terms that you need to understand, because if you're communicating with your technicians at Invisalign or ClearCorrect, or even just communicating with our team about the orthodontic movements for your patient, you want to understand the difference. Otherwise, if we're talking about apples and you're talking about oranges, it gets really confusing. And I feel like a lot of GPs get confused on these terms. So I just want to define them so that you can speak like an orthodontist in communicating with people. So let's talk about the difference between expansion and proclination. So let's start with proclination. Proclination, the definition that I would say, you know, maybe people talk about it differently, is leaning out the front teeth. So this is going to be in response to these eight front teeth is going to be a proclination. That means basically tipping them forward. Okay, that's all it means. So I would say these two teeth, these twos, are proclined. These two teeth are retroclined. All four of these teeth are retroclined. So proclination is the opposite of retroclination. Okay, I can ask the text to please procline these six teeth. Okay, or please do not procline these teeth. So sometimes when I do a setup, I'll say they're in Invisalign, they have that checkbox that says proclination, yes, primarily, as needed, not at all. So if there's a case where I'm like, yikes, I definitely don't want them to procline those incisors, like let's say, for example, that's part of the reason that Ceph x-rays are really helpful, because right now, my eye is really good. I don't even need to get the numbers. I can tell you that these incisors are very, very proclined, and these incisors are proclined, but not dangerously proclined. So if I was doing this setup, I mean, clearly this case is maxillary deficient in class 3, I would say, do not procline the maxillary incisors or the mandibular incisors. I'd say do not procline is what I'd say. So now you understand that term. Now let's go over to the term expansion. Now, expansion can mean two different things. There is skeletal expansion, and I've done a video about this before, so you're welcome to look through my phase one videos on my homepage of Straight Smile Solutions YouTube to watch them. So there's skeletal expansion, where you're putting in an appliance and physically breaking the upper jaw and moving it wider to expand the arches. And there's dental expansion, which basically means tipping the teeth to make the arch wider. Both are fine. Both are a little bit different. In kids, of course, we want skeletal expansion. You're probably not going to get that in adults, so you're going to get dental expansion. Regardless, you're getting arch expansion. We expand the whole arch, but usually it involves the sides moving buccally. So with proclination, we were talking about the front teeth. Now we're talking about the back teeth, okay? Widening that arch out, expanding that arch, okay? What's the opposite? Constriction. We don't really use that very often in ortho. It's mostly expansion, right? Expansion is good. It gives you a better position for the tongue, gives you a better airway. Always better expansion than constriction. All right. Thanks so much. Hopefully that was helpful. Take care.